Hello, folks. Robert from Marine Depot here, and welcome to another episode of our drop-off tank build. In the last episode, we asked all of you guys which additives we should use in the aquarium. Well, the Red Sea Reef Foundation won the vote, so stick around to see how we apply these additives to our aquarium, get an update on the tank, and hear about what's in store for the next episode. Red Sea's Reef Foundation program provides a complete solution for maintaining and replenishing the major elements in a reef tank. The Red Sea program is actually made of three different solutions that, when used correctly, will maintain calcium, alkalinity, and magnesium at the proper ratio. The additives are available in both a liquid and dry powder form. To get started, we took three of the AquaMaxx dosing containers, one for each of the components, and labeled them appropriately. This labeling is pretty important with two or three part calcium buffer solutions because you never want to accidentally mix the solutions. This would basically render the additives useless, not to mention clog up your tubing. We hooked up the dosing chambers to our Kamoer dosing pump and secured the dosing lines to our sump. The lines are above the water line to prevent any risk of back siphoning through the tubing. In order to calculate the tank's demand and ultimately the daily dosage, we followed the instructions laid out by Red Sea. We first performed a large water change and then tested the tank parameters to ensure that everything was at the desired level. Next, we referenced the handy Red Sea Reef Care recipe for a mixed reef tank. These recipes make it really easy not only to see the desired parameters for your tank type, but also provide you with a baseline to start your dosing regimen. We started with the average daily dosage for our tank size, which equates to 9 milliliters of Foundation A, 27 milliliters of Foundation B, and 3 milliliters of Foundation C. I then set the Kamoer dosing pump to deliver the appropriate amounts of each solution using the handy app, which was quick and painless. After the first 7 days, we noticed the alkalinity and calcium were slowly dipping out of range, so we simply increased the daily dosage of each solution. Since then, the parameters have been maintained fairly steady. We will continue to test on a weekly basis to ensure that our dosing regimen is keeping up with the tank. We have removed some of the rock work on the top level of the aquarium to accommodate the flow inside of the tank. The top shallow portion was pretty turbulent, and now with a bit more open space up top, the corals seem to be doing much better. We added a starry blenny along with a few new corals into the tank and finally noticed one of the two Spotsynctus clownfish hosting inside of the anemone. The algae reactor is doing great and is growing rapidly. We're removing macroalgae on a weekly basis at this point. We're noticing less nuisance algae in the tank, and in combination with the addition of a blenny, the bare rocks are looking much cleaner. All through this video series, we had intentions of installing an aquarium controller, and I'm thrilled to say that we've finally reached the point that it's time to install our Neptune Systems Apex controller. Automating and monitoring this aquarium with the Apex system is going to be a huge help for all of us here at the office, and ideally help us to create an even more impressive reef tank to share with you guys. So stay tuned to watch us install some of the latest and greatest gadgets from Neptune Systems, and get some handy tips on how to retrofit an aquarium controller onto your existing reef tank. I do appreciate all of you for following along with us through this tank build video series, and give us a like and share with your friends if you found it interesting. Until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.